Tonight I brought a different Tesla coil. This one I'm just going to use to amp up the energy.
It seems like there's an old man who's real hostile. He's backing up.
Or if you look straight up at the corner,
like the
ceiling.
Top of the
corner. Yeah. And that's where you get all your headaches. And
yeah, I'm looking up. What's up there? Me?
He's in for murder. He was arrested for murder over here.
Been getting a lot of names. Yeah, my name came up quite a bit.
Okay, something was touching my thumb.
Yeah. I'll do the same thing. I feel the same way.
My head.
What?
It starts hurting.
That's the raise the hair on your neck.
Corner.
I just thought I saw something.
We heard something fall in the room next to us. Jose's checking it out.
This just said poltergeist.
We're here at the Hood County Jail Museum, and this actually was once a log cabin back in the early 1900s, and it got to a point where there were so many prisoners that they needed to build something bigger, and that's what you're seeing today. I don't know if you can see it on the camera. They started to renovate this in 1885, and it took about a year, so it was the only jail that both the city and the county use. Those of you that are familiar with some history, Granbury is known for a lot of outlaws that pass through this area. We're not too far from the Brazos River. So we're here at the county jail. We're gonna go inside and talk to a couple volunteers and get a little bit of backstory about what's happening at this jail, and then we'll start our investigation. Here we have Alan, and he's one of the volunteers here. And
howdy.
So you've had some experience. Can you tell us that one that you told me earlier about the steps?
So I was sitting here by myself. It was after one of the paranormal things we did. It was winding down and coming down the stairs. It sounded like somebody was really angry and stomping, and they were wearing spurs, and you could hear the spurs jingle. And then they made it to the landing, and they never made it to the wooden floor. It's like they stood there and I thought that...
Like they were looking at
they
you?
They were staring at me like they were mad, you know, and I went outside.
Okay.
But that's the weirdest thing.
The weirdest
thing. Things have fallen off walls. And you always hear people walking around. And, you know, sometimes you hear like jazz music from back in the back, you know. That's okay. The weirdest.
In case we are still live streaming, just so you know, the spirits are already interfering with the equipment. So Ben's going to just do a real quick check. But right now we're going to go in the back and we're going to set up and get a spirit box session going. So you want to follow me back here? And there's some bad weather coming in right now, so hopefully that'll help with the spirits. What we're going to start off with first is, if you're familiar with us and you watched our last live stream, I had the Tesla coil with us. Tonight I brought a different Tesla coil. This one I'm just going to use to amp up the energy, and then we're going to start the spirit box session. So let me plug this in and get this going. So I'd like to invite spirits to come forward and communicate with us tonight. Hopefully this will help you. You know, you can tap into this energy and you'll be able to communicate with us better. Now, you guys said there's a woman, Sarah? Is it Sarah or Sally?
No, it's Sarah, and Lisa's normally here, but it's Sarah.
Sarah.
Yeah.
Sarah, are you here with us? I swore that just said priest. Is there anybody here with us right now? We want to communicate with whoever's in this building.
Day. History.
Sorry. That's okay.
What did that say?
The day in history. I was just trying to see if by chance these two devices kind of correlate with each other.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah. All right, just so you know, I didn't formally introduce us to you, and I apologize for that. My name's Michelle.
I like the party.
I like the party. Ben has the camera. We have Father Ruben. We have Jose. Actually, and I forgot to even mention that, Jose is from Finding the Paranormal. So go like his page. He's a really cool guy.
FTP.
FTP comes out to investigate with us. We love having him with us. He's got some really cool devices tonight that we're going to use. And then also we have
Alan.
Alan,
And Bob.
And Bob with us. So
way up
now that you know our names, can you tell us your name? Is your name Susan? Are you here?
You didn't introduce me.
Yeah, I did.
Did you? What did you say?
After
Ben
me.
With the camera.
Ben
oh,
with the
Ben
camera.
With the camera.
Now, we always get Ben's name, so.
Yeah, let's see.
Say Jose.
Bit coming out now.
Say Jose.
I got clairvoyant right off the bat.
And so you have the ovulus, right? The ovulus
yes.
Five?
You know what's kind of interesting is they kind of like that electric thing you had.
They like the Tesla coil?
Mm-hmm.
Pop it back on.
When I was at the door, you turned it on and you were telling them they weren't going to get hurt by it. Because they're right there. Right here.
You want to see the Tesla coil?
Right.
Put a little shopping.
Well, now you really got it going on.
There you go.
Anything saying?
Stars, Robert.
It said stars?
Yeah.
Kind of looks like stars.
Yeah, it does.
It's the same.
Age, people, monitor.
Do you see Ben with the camera? What is it?
Mind.
Yeah.
She ain't still standing there, is she?
Do you like the music?
Let's try it a little more here.
It said Lisa.
Five. Lisa's sad. Here?
It's sad. Who's Lisa?
She's sad.
Wed.
It's detecting something right there.
Does the music make you sad? Like sad music?
I said to come to Jose.
Why are you sad?
I like to hear that play.
The dog trap room, which is the next room.
Can you come back in here, please? Yeah, because this is quiet.
Why are they being like that is beyond me.
Thank you.
Yes, we
okay.
Like
now, since you came closer, speak to us. Put some more words on this device. Cold.
You know,
yeah,
funny.
Like it's cold.
It's cold right here. Do you feel that?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm cold. I mean, I can feel a draft behind me.
Do you want us to go upstairs? I know she's booting us out from here.
Yeah.
I'm thinking there's too many of us in this room. Because usually there's more than like three people in here.
Yeah, they get...
Yeah.
Want upstairs?
Yeah, let's do everything like we were going to do with live.
It's around the side. It's fixing to do it like once. It's fixing to do it again.
Well, it's
because
it's the
see,
motion he's
I
right
don't.
There.
Yeah.
Ruben called it.
Let's go upstairs.
I thought he was going to touch it. Mr. Morris, are you here? I heard Morris. I'm saying he's Mr. Morris.
So we're upstairs at the Hood County Jail. This area here, there's only two cell blocks. This is where the men would stay. Hmm. And these cells
oh,
are dinky.
I got scared. I got
that's
startled
creepy.
For a second because I saw the hair and I was like, what is that?
Okay, so that's like a motion detector as well.
Yeah.
And it has like, you know, like on both sides.
It's going off.
So that one went off, but this one went off.
Which one went off first?
He's there, he's there.
So is that that? That's that pyramid.
Yeah. So.
We're getting activity. I want to go run and get the SLS. The other cell, I wanted to just say that real quick.
Oh, go in there.
Yeah.
Oh, you're going there. Yeah.
So this cell was only strictly for women and the crazy people. And this is a very dinky cell, but...
Better than the other one.
Huh?
At least you have a high ceiling in here. It's better than the other one.
So I'm going to go, since it's getting activity, I'm going to go get the SLS. I'll be right back.
So what are you feeling there, Ruben? Anything?
Oh, that's the one of the prisoners. That's his area there. He's trying to say, that's my area.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody goes to it.
Now that would be thunder outside. We got a pretty good little thunder.
Watch.
And
shine it up to that corner.
I had
something.
It's still
locked up.
Up in that corner?
I walked in here.
Especially looking at that corner right there. Mm-hmm. That's where you see it. I don't know.
So are we
going to
be doing stuff in here?
Oh, I don't know. We haven't done anything in that back corner. The last time we were here,
yeah.
We did nothing in that corner where that hole is. That was so. I just feel like y'all should do something there.
Disregard,
yeah. Disregard that room.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll figure out a way because for some reason it don't want to identify itself.
I don't know
why. Are you in here? Just be careful if you guys walk in here in the dark, there's a step up. You're gonna trip.
Robert again? That's that guy downstairs. They're mad at him because there's all these people.
I had something. Can you show yourself? You're hiding back here, aren't you? I think he went to the cell over here. You don't have to be afraid of us.
There's another stepper.
Yeah, I stripped on it. Ben.
Yeah.
Right here. He's at the door. Up. Can you come back, please?
What's your name? You gonna tell us your name?
Martin.
Mark.
Was it Martin?
Martin. There you see him. Sam.
I'm a cop.
There's two of them. Do you see him?
Yeah, but that thing said I'm a cop. Close that down, lady.
Look. See that?
Yeah.
Picture.
Is the figure still in the SLS? Or?
No, it kind of popped in and out. There were two at one point, and then they went away.
Here, come into the jail cell.
Lisa.
Lisa?
Yeah.
Who's Lisa?
Who's Lisa?
Do we know a Lisa?
No, it's Sarah and Lisa's normally here, but it's Sarah.
What's the story of that hole that's there? Isn't there something to do with that hole that's back there? Or that was
they tried to escape.
Yeah, when was that?
Oh, wow. There's like six different escapes.
Okay, but it was kind of that same, not that same hole.
Yeah,
but
where the guards can't see, that's where things happen.
Yeah.
And that's why I asked if y'all been back there yet, because it's like...
Sorry.
That's the raise the hair on your neck corner.
Stop.
Ben.
Did you say obvious? It's a step away.
Ben. Guys, twice.
Ben. You know, we always get Ben's name, so.
Yeah. Let's see.
Say Jose.
Ben's coming out now.
Say Jose.
Devil. Devil. Pain, suffering.
Come on, one at a time.
Propaganda. It's all, are you saying this is all propaganda? You guys are just feeding us a lot of bull?
Where's the volume?
You want some Jack Daniels?
I could go for some JD.
Who is in here with us? You have to give us your name. We have to know who to address. And if there's more than one spirit, just don't talk over each other. Just one at a time, please.
Alan.
Just one at a time, please.
Alan. What was the name of the man that escaped and then came back with a bushel of peaches?
I feel like this. Right there.
Brett?
Oh, that's a good one.
Brett?
No, Frank.
Oh, Frank? You heard Frank?
He's out.
He's out.
All right.
Who was Frank? Oh, that's his door right there. Who was Frank?
He's in for murder. He was arrested for murder over here.
Okay.
He's in the first cell. And between the two cells, they're very active. You may want to move
in there.
In the interact.
But that was Frank. Did he get out? Did he try to escape or anything?
No.
Walter, oh, okay. Are you still here?
Okay. Well, we did get Lisa on the obelisk up here.
Yeah.
And Jesse, did you come?
Seems like there's an old man who's real hostile. He's backing up. You don't want to get close to him.
This is where they tried to escape right there.
Okay. Oh, I see. Uh-oh. He's right here.
So we're looking, we're focused on this hole right there.
Oh.
This is where we're looking. Are you sensing anything, Ruben?
I feel heaviness right here.
Okay.
There's kind of a heaviness. Whatever it is, it's right here. It's, see, it looks like it's above me. And I kind of feel kind of a heavy energy here.
There's something right in, no, there's something
in between you.
You and Father Ruben.
Yeah, that's where the hole is, right there.
Yeah, it's stuck on the screen. Oh, now it's right in front of you, Ben.
See, it's heavy.
It's stuck in the hole.
Yeah.
That's what she said.
That's where the portal is.
It's a heavy.
Just jumped in the hole, I'm telling you.
Right.
Yeah, it's here.
That's what they said. They said things coming in and out, and this is where stuff comes in and out.
Yeah. It's like a heaviness here, real heavy. I mean,
yeah.
It really is heavy.
Yeah.
Who did I see standing right here? Can you tell us your name? Did you see us? Alright, let me try to get the
SLS
back up again.
It feels warm right there.
Yeah.
Like I can feel energy right there.
No, it's there. It's heavy. It really is a different.
Like when I put my hand right there, I can just feel like my palm is warm.
I'm sure you do feel it. I'm sweating bullets.
You sweat. Yeah, it's weird because
it is.
Yeah, because I pull it away. I pull my hand away if I put my hand in there, and then I pull it away. But I can feel. It feels like there's like something out coming off the rocks. You know.
It was almost like it was trying to check out what you were doing.
Mm-hmm.
I almost want to go to that. Like, have you near the hole, and I'm going to go back down that way. Can you come out of the portal, please? You can hear my voice. Come follow my voice. Call upon those entities that are in that hole. Can you come out, please?
I'm calling upon the entities in the hole.
Right here.
That's what she said.
Now, are these supposed to be good or bad? Are these the bad ones or the good ones?
I don't think there's really any bad.
No, any of them can come and go.
It's like a portal?
Yes.
Oh yeah, there's a big ass one right behind you, Ben.
That's me.
He wants the whiskey.
I think they're really curious what Ben's holding. Like, they're like, what is that?
But they want what I'm holding.
Go to Jose. Jose has some liquor. Here.
I'll let you smell it. You want to smell it?
Cheers.
Breathe in that fresh air.
It's just super hot right here in this corner.
So hot back here.
There's like no draft.
All right, so this one's static. It's like if I put it in my phone. Any figures?
Huh? I think it went out. It went out.
My battery. I have battery, so it's on the battery.
Are you trying to boot it back up, or are you done?
I'm kind of done because I'm like, I can't breathe.
Okay. I guess Michelle went downstairs, huh?
Yeah, where's she going?
I thought she was in that other cell, but she's not. We did get Lisa, and he's saying there's a Lisa. I mean, he's confirming a Lisa. He said there was a Frank.
You got a Walter.
Yeah, you said you got a Walter. He said there was a Walter. What's the other guy's name? Not Bob, but...
Adam.
Adam?
Alan.
Oh, Alan. Yeah. He's saying that back cell, where the dummy is back there, he's saying that's the one that gives him the heebie-jeebies. So I think we should try to do like a spirit box or something there.
Yep, I think we should.
Go ahead, Ruben. Yeah, we won't want to stay in there too long. It's pretty warm. There's another step. Yeah.
There's a dummy in here?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
What?
Eva.
Yeah.
Make.
You said evil?
Evil.
Yeah. Are we making
evil, draw, make. A little humid.
Okay, something was touching my thumb. This button right here on the far right is where my thumb is sitting, and that button doesn't move. But my finger was like shaking, like it was being touched.
Tell us your name. Do you need help?
I'm in jail. That's what it sounded like. It said, I'm in jail.
No.
Yeah, I gotta go out. I'm sweating. Too hot. Have you done anything in that lady's cell?
I didn't get anything.
Oh, you went in there?
Yeah, but you can't. I don't know where the light switch is.
You want to bring that in to here, to the ladies?
This is the ladies' stuff?
The ladies and the crazy people.
Yeah, because
the men were only on that side.
Because you heard him tell the story, the lady that tried to escape from here, and she dug through the wall, but she dug through the wrong wall, and she ended up in the men's cell over there. When did they stop using this jail?
1978.
Oh, okay. I can't imagine. 1978, and they still got people
almost
locked up.
Almost 100 years it was running.
Having people locked up in that room over there in 1978? That seems like something that should be from the 1800s, you know? It's like.
But you know what? The new jail that's not too far from here, I looked up, there's a lot of murders that happened over there.
Yeah.
And I wonder if those spirits are.
Yeah.
They know. Well. Paranormal groups come out here, so
that my cousin, the one my cousin took care of, she was from Granbury.
Oh, really?
She lives in Granbury.
Whenever I'm in here, though, my head starts hurting.
I'll do the same thing. I feel the same way.
My head.
What?
It starts hurting when I'm in there.
I feel a little.
You know what? It's probably the crazy people who are in there.
I just feel hot.
I know. I'm just hot, man.
Are you messing with Michelle? It's like Ben, like three times in a row.
Are you the guy that Bob said that you want to talk to me? I actually feel sick to my stomach. I think I have to go downstairs for a few minutes.
I could use some water.
Are you going to follow us downstairs? Or maybe they all just came out because they knew we were going down.
Yeah.
All right, we'll be back.
Do you have any luck, Michelle?
We caught one guy going into that second jail cell, and then two guys popped up.
It sounded like it said his name was Mark or...
Martin.
It was either Mark or Martin, but it didn't sound, right after that, it sounded like it said, I'm a cop. What's your name? You going to tell us your name?
Martin.
Mark.
Was it Martin?
There he is. See him?
I'm a cop.
Interesting.
Why?
Because no one's ever gotten a Martin before. Very good. I can vouch for that.
Oh, you can? What do you mean?
Do you think that's the angry old man trying to get the name?
Wait, what do you mean you can vouch for that?
So that's confirmation.
Spirit?
It's in spirit, yeah.
Who's Mr. Morris?
What did you say? Wait, what did you say, Ruben? Who?
Look up on the wall.
Morris? Did you say, I thought you said Morris. Said Morris?
Morris.
He's the very first sheriff in this building.
That's why I said he's here.
Yes, he is.
Where's Mr. Where's
that,
Morris
that
at?
That very might, well might be the guy you're
just
talking about. Look.
Oh, thank no, you.
That's not a dude to mess with. He was like, so like, they don't make a movie about him. So, you know, they always show the movies where.
Yeah, because I.
So a guy murdered somebody
encounter?
Here in town.
That's right.
And then they took off to California and Morris got on a horse, went up there, got him and brought him back alive. You know, that never happened because it's just so dangerous to bring him back alive. But then like 2 years later, somebody did it again and took off to Montana and he went to Montana and got run by. You know, you didn't mess with that dude.
Huh. Yeah. He kind of looks like Kurt Russell. He reminds me of Wyatt Earp.
That's him. That's him standing right there in the center with the crazy bowed leg. That's
him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah, you didn't mess with
him.
You're
giving me good names, so you guys are doing good.
are we getting tested here? Is this a test?
Okay, so he's here.
There's a few drops. So what, you got a, what did you, what's your thing?
I haven't really felt anything.
Yeah, no, but
you don't have to feel anything, but you're getting.
It's just the names. I mean, the names are interesting, and it's like
that's
correlating with whatever the gentleman is. Robert,
Bob, or Robert. Yeah, Bob. Same thing. But that's the same thing with me. Like I don't always feel something, but you're hearing things. Like I got Martin. I'm a cop.
Is it Martin?
Martin, there you Sam.
I'm a cop, and then he's like, "Yeah, there's a Martin, a cop." So you're getting things that.
And now I'm kind of curious on the pyramid because I mean, it's just constantly going off. I just wonder if it's hitting like part of the wall or something to where it's like, it's setting it off.
Yeah.
Pyramid on the bed?
Yeah.
No, because it was quiet when you guys were in the jail cell. It wasn't doing anything.
Yeah.
Until I started talking to it. When you use the ovulus, does it talk a lot or was tonight like unusual? Because I was talking a lot.
Yeah.
But then, no, we there were spots where it wasn't saying anything.
Now, the music box, on the other hand, that one was pretty cool. Because, I mean, it's just right doorway, nothing there, and it's going off. And then it's like when I had it right there, that was kind of freaky. Why is it detecting something?
She ain't still standing there, is she?
Because it's like, why is it not cutting it off? I'm like, maybe because something's standing right there.
Something making it go off, off and off
outside.
And off.
Outside, my head was starting, like I was getting all this pressure.
It's
in my
all
head.
That lead paint you're breathing in there.
Could be.
Well, I was just going to say, I debunked something that I thought my thumb was touched.
Okay, something was touching my thumb.
Okay.
But now it was the actual wheel right here. It's like I had my thumb here, and I felt like something was touching my thumb. But
hitting it. Yeah.
The biggest thing that I took away right now, we've been getting a lot of names, but, and you'll cut
like
this.
20 times.
You can cut the, yeah, my name came up quite a bit, but that one that said Martin, and then it said I'm a cop, like that was totally random. Like we didn't have that name or anything. And we came downstairs and Bob said, there is a Martin. He's confirming it. I mean, we're going by his confirmation. I don't know. He doesn't have proof to show us firsthand, but he said he has seen him, or he's gotten a Martin and that it was a cop, so.
Yeah.
That was pretty interesting. And we've gotten some other things. Lisa, because he said there was a Lisa.
Here, come into the jail cell.
Lisa.
Lisa?
Yeah.
No, it's Sarah and Lisa.
And then Father Ruben said he picked up on a Morris, and Morris was actually the first sheriff here. So, supposedly a pretty bad dude, apparently, so.
Who's Mr. Morris?
He's the very first sheriff in this building.
That's why I said he's here.
Yes, he is.
Interesting. So we are picking up things that are correlating the stuff that happens here, and they didn't tell us that before. I think right now we'll go back in, and then we'll do some solo sessions upstairs. We'll have like somebody go upstairs, and we'll maybe do like a split screen or something, and have us talking.
Yeah, let's do that. Cause
let's do some solo sessions.
Some solo sessions.
Do you see
shadow people? No, we haven't been drinking.
Oh yeah. By the way, where is that Jack Daniels? I could do a little shot of it.
You want to get it? Put it on.
Can we do
a
shot? Is it an open bottle or brand new bottle?
No, it's just a small little bottle.
Oh, is it open though?
No.
You're on the live.
Can we open it up and take a swig?
You can if you want.
Oh, yeah, see, you got that.
Yeah, we brought that for Jesse James if he followed us over from the cemetery.
Yes, here's to you, Jesse James.
Well, now to Morris. Was Morris the sheriff?
Mm-hmm. Well, here's to you, Mr. Morris.
Here's to you.
Martin.
Martin?
Don't drink it all.
Here's
pog.
To you, Lisa.
Gotta say something to the spirits.
I know.
Just a toast to
you. Know, at one point, it was yours. I was getting angry, actually. I don't know what that was.
Because everyone was talking and you wanted everyone to shut up because you were trying to do something. That's what that was. I know what that was.
Now that's debunked.
Yeah.
Debunked.
So anyway, guys, what we're doing now is we're just going to have a little solo session. People are going to go upstairs. And we're going to have one person up there by themselves, probably lights out. And then we'll be down here controlling the camera and watching them. And then they'll just kind of see because... They said that sometimes when you have too many people, things don't happen. So they don't like a lot of commotion. So we're going to slow it down, get one or two people up there, or just one person, maybe two, and then we'll see what happens. And we'll be watching down here for that.
So again, I want to communicate with whoever was trying to communicate with me earlier. I know you were affecting me. I was getting like really hard pressure on my forehead and on the top of my head. It's so quiet. There's like nothing happening. Can you make something move in here? A knock. Make that music box go off. Are you just watching me? It says empath. Yes, I'm an empath. Come on, give me a sign that you're here. Make a noise. I need to know that I'm communicating with somebody. Can you show yourself? They say that you're angry. Oh, I just thought I saw. I just thought I, oh, I got the chills. I just thought I saw something on this corner. I just thought I saw something on this corner, and this just said poltergeist. This just said poltergeist. Okay.
I know I'm kind of talking over Michelle, but we heard something fall in the room next to us. Jose's checking it out. But something fell.
I felt totally drained, like. I appreciate you trying to show yourself to me. I know I saw something in that corner, and it was just kind of strange that the said poltergeist just said something again. It said base. Alright, I'm going to go down to home base and let somebody else come up here.
Bottle of whiskey in my hand. What kind of whiskey is it? Karen? You got the name Karen. Jack Daniels? Yes or no?
Karen works here, by the way. So the fact that he got Karen, that's somebody that works here. The one that was our contact to come here. I mean, she's alive. She's here. She works at the place.
I guess you can't. Daniels, yes or no? You want me to leave you this bottle? Yes? Was that a yes? Got multiple devices here. All you gotta do is make one go off and I'll leave this bottle for you. It's right here. Okay, I'm gonna take off and I'm gonna take the bottle with me. Last call for alcohol. Come on. Do something.
Yeah, if you go through the door, if you look straight up at the corner,
like the
ceiling,
top of the corner, yeah. That's where the thing is. Yeah,
and that's where you get all your headaches.
Whenever I'm in here, though, my head starts
hurting. I'll do the same thing. I feel the same way.
My head.
What?
Starts hurting.
And everything's coming from
I think
that.
I'll go in there.
That's the only negative.
That's that black part. Blob thing?
Yeah.
Huh? That's that black blob
black,
thing?
I call it the black blob.
I think that's where I'll go.
You and me, kid. Just you and me in here. So I need you to give me a little sign that maybe you're here. Who's here with me in this room? Anybody? Hey, I heard my name. Did you hear my name?
Was this spirit energy that just passed over Ben and said hello?
I'm gonna be with you.
Okay. Were y'all hearing anything from there?
Yeah.
I mean, did I
really? I saw a shadow coming behind you.
Oh, really?
Yeah, maybe how you went down this way.
Oh, that?
On the right, on the other side.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna go ahead and
anybody need the prayers and blessings?
Okay.
How long have you been here?
I said kill.
That's what I said, yeah.
And you said, how many men said kill?
Kill who?
You killed somebody, or you died in this...
Or somebody building. Killed you.
Yeah. They said yes. You killed someone?
Bitch.
No.
Okay.
So if somebody killed you, or you died here.
Is there a woman here? And you want me to pray for you that you may go to the light? I can help you. In order to find peace in your spirit form as a soul, you would have to receive Christ. That's how it's done.
Are you ready to do that?
I can only tell you the truth, because it is. The only way you can seek is peace. If you have peace, it is through yourself. You must let go of everything that burns you down, hold you to this earth.
That said, help me.
Okay. You must seek peace through Christ. You must let go of your anger, bitterness, forgive others and what they've done to your life, and let go.
All right, well, Ruben gave you the info that you need. And
that's what you need.
And he's obviously given you information and given you the way to seek peace, or whatever it is
you seek peace, and the more you achieve peace through Christ, then later your soul is restored. And then you can see the light.
So if you're good with that, I think we're gonna let you be now.
Okay.
And we'll
find
the light.
I'll give you first the blessings. Bless you in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I'm just like just trying to say amen. I'm gonna sound like I heard thank you. We're going to go back downstairs, so...
Okay.
Hope that helps you, and you can find the peace, or whatever it is you can do to give yourself some...
See, everything kind of got a little peace. Quiet here.
Yeah.
I noticed that.
Hood County Jail definitely had paranormal activity during the investigation. Once again, Ben's name was being called out throughout the night. Ben and I usually have our names called out, but recently, the spirits have been really trying to get his attention. We need to figure out a way on our next investigation and have Ben really focus on starting a dialogue with these spirits to see if we can get some more concrete evidence.
What, Ben?
Ben?
Oh, crap.
Let's see, Ben.
I knew you were going to say that.
It did.
Oh!
It said it did.
Is that you over by the ice machine?
Ben.
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 Hey, I heard my name.
It's like Ben like three times in a row.
Father Ruben was sensing spirits the moment we entered the jail. When we were upstairs in the jail cell, Father Ruben kept telling us a man named Morris was trying to get his attention.
Is it Ben?
Huh?
She's in the bed right now. Who's Mr. Morris?
We caught two figures on the SLS when we asked who they were. One said, Martin, I'm a cop.
You gonna tell us your name?
Martin.
Mark?
Was it Martin?
Martin, there he is, see him? See him?
I'm a cop.
There's two of them, do you see him?
Yeah, but that thing said, I'm a cop.
Could Sheriff Morris and Martin the cop still be roaming the building? During each solo session, we did capture some type of paranormal activity. I find it compelling that after I had asked the spirits to give me a sign that they acknowledged me, the guys downstairs heard something being knocked over.
If you're really here with me, can you please give me a sign?
We heard something fall in the room next to us. Jose's checking it out.
Then when I asked the spirits to show themselves to me, I saw a shadow in the doorway of the jail cell.
And this just said poltergeist.
Did one of the spirits just knock something over at base camp and then tell me poltergeist? Was he or she trying to show themselves to me in the doorway? We caught these light anomalies during Jose's session in the jail cell. The first one is shooting away from Jose's back. The second one is coming back towards Jose. Were they trying to check out the bottle of Jack Daniels?
You want me to leave you this bottle? Yes?
Yet, but when Ben and Father Ruben were up there doing their solo, they were getting some pretty cool stuff. And when you were asking Father Ruben, do you need help? Do you need prayers? We could hear it down here. I don't think you guys heard nearly as much as we heard. It was saying, help, help me, help.
I'm just going to go back downstairs and we'll let somebody else come up here. What was that? Is that a help me? Help you what?
I can help you.
We send good thoughts and prayers to those lost souls looking for peace. The energy in the jail seemed to have shifted. It felt calmer and lighter by the end of the night.
Something came off.
Yeah, it felt lighter up there.
I felt like all of a sudden.
Because I was starting to, like, you starting to get kind of a headache and just not. But then after he did that, it felt a lot fresher.
Yeah,
the air
released,
and stuff like
pressure.
That.
I mean, I feel good now.
The air and everything, just the air and everything like that.
Everything went,
fresher.
Yeah, exactly. That's what
I felt a lot cooler, too,
I feel
for
great.
Some reason.
All of a sudden, I feel good. I just did something to release whatever's there.
Yeah.
You definitely feel like the different vibes, the different energies.
Yes.
I gotta go downstairs.
Okay. You know, because we were having headaches early on.
Oh, yes.
And
I was too.
Had
I was
to go good. Outside, get some fresh air, get our energy back. So this place is legit. There's definitely stuff here. So all in all, it was a good night tonight.
It was. A lot of history. Feel the history. And you can smell the history, too.
I like the lab. Okay.
Peace out.
Peace out.
And bless you all.
Mystic Ghost. Subscribe and scratch on notifications if you dare.